offensive coordinator Pete Sterbick now joining us. Pete, reflecting back on Drake, frustrating, I think, from the main point. The team didn't get to come away with some points twice in the red zone, but from the offensive perspective, just a general rundown of how you thought things went.
Well, there's a lot of ways to lose games. This one was about as frustrating as it gets. Going into the game, we had an idea coming off their game against North Dakota what we were going to get defensively, but then had also heard some things about their D coordinator and what he runs, and which we didn't see against North Dakota. So we kind of meshed those two, and actually that's what we got. We got a little bit of both, and our kids were prepared, and we got ourselves into some good situations, but we didn't play a complete game, so we didn't close it out. And you know, there's definitely some positives, that's for sure. You know, that's why we were in the game. But there's definitely enough room for improvement that we got a lot of work to do.
What happened with the touchdown passes that Greg found Darren three times?
Well, we got to third down, and I think it was third down and eight on the first one, and just trying to get the corner to bite inside. We wheeled Darren and Gavin both on each side, but there's more room. There was more room to Darren's side, so that's kind of the side I thought maybe we'd go to, and Taylor Goble was able to squeeze the corner inside, and pretty easy throw and catch for Greg and Darren. And then the second one was a heck of a play. Just a simple play action, and Darren runs a bubble to the sideline, and got a couple great blocks from Mike Kennick, and then Darren just made things happen, which is great to see. And then the third one, Darren was actually open on the same play, the play before, and so we switched formation and shifted to it to kind of disguise it, but they actually ended up being in a different coverage, which was fine. We had talked about the situation happening, and Darren did exactly how you draw it up, and Greg made a great throw.
How about the running game? How do you felt the running game went with Dante and Daryl basically splitting the yardage pretty much?
Yeah, we were productive. You know, overall production-wise, you know, we were a lot better than the last time we played Drake, and we were able to pick up first downs on third downs by running the ball, and it wasn't just third and one or two. I think three or four times it was third and five or six, and we ran the ball and got it. And one time we ran a real simple read play and got 21 yards on third and 16. And you know, I know that's frustrating for their defense. So we were able to keep our drives going and keep the ball in our hands because of that. So I thought for the most part it was pretty good. It was better than the week before.
And from the time of possession perspective, you Grandview outdid Drake by about 6 minutes. You have to be, you know, glad you kept them away from the football.
Yeah, it just drives you nuts when you don't get points. That's the biggest thing. But you know, you give yourself a chance when you have the ball in your hands.
What happened on the first down or the first and goal from the one? And then the four consecutive plays just didn't get in, according to the officials.
Yeah, and part of that's my fault, that's for sure. Called back-to-back same play on first and second down, and we didn't block it the way that we should have the first time or the second time. And then that third down, I thought he was in. The referee's got the best angle on the field because he's right there on the sideline, and apparently he didn't see Dante cross the goal line. And then, you know, I probably should have got us into something different sometime in there instead of running the ball, but you'd like to think you'd just be able to pound that thing in when you're that close. So.
Okay, now to Trinity on Saturday. What kind of things, in general, do you think they present to you defensively?
Well, I thought we did a nice job of getting back to the basics in our run game. And so that was good to see. And going into this game, they mix it up a little bit with their fronts and their coverages. You know, they do some different things with their corners pressed up, and they bail. And you know, I don't know necessarily that we're going to have to invent anything new. I just think we need to be, you know, fundamental and man for man across the board. We got to do our job. I don't think it's going to take anything fancy for us to be successful, but it's going to take us playing good football. You know, specific plays and stuff like that, you know, I think that'll come upon situation. But I think the things that we have in our offense are going to be able to be what we need to get the job done. We just have to, you know, each guy's got to do his job.
All right, Pete, thanks. That's offensive coordinator Pete Sterbick.